Emily on behalf of BBM Global welcome you all to our project day of this year. Our topic for our project day is Role of Indian Soldiers in World War II. World War II started on 1st September 1939 and ended at 2nd September 1945. This lasted for 6 years. Now my friends will speak about the causes of World War II and the rise of the ambitious leader like Adolf Hitler and Benito Mussolini. They'll also shed some light how India was dragged into it.
The Second World War began on September 1st, 1939 when Germany invaded Poland and it went on till 1945. The principal belligerents were the Axis powers and the Allies. The Axis powers were Germany, Italy and Japan, and the Allies were France, Great Britain, the United States, the Soviet Union and to the lesser extent China. Let's discuss the causes of the war. The causes of the war were the dissatisfaction caused by unjust treaty of Versailles, the rise of fascism and Nazism, the policy of appeasement followed by the Western powers, Japan's invasion of China in 1931, the failure of League of Nations, and lastly, Hitler's invasion of Poland.
The main events of the war were: on September 1, 1939, German armies marched into Poland. France and Germany gave an ultimatum to Germany, and in reply, Germany attacked France. On September 3, 1939, Britain and France declared war on Germany. Germany, Italy, Japan formed an alliance called the Axis powers, whereas Britain, France and the USA formed another alliance known as Allied powers.
Adolf Hitler, the leader of Germany's Nazi party, was one of the most powerful and notorious dictators of the 20th century. Hitler capitalized on economic woes, powerful discontent and political infighting to take absolute power in Germany beginning in 1933. Germany's invasion of Poland in 1939 led to the outbreak of World War II. By 1941, Nazi forces had occupied much of Europe. Hitler's virulent anti-Semitism and obsessive pursuit of Aryan supremacy fueled the murder of some 6 million Jews, along with the other victims of the Holocaust. After the tide of war turned against him, Hitler committed suicide in a Berlin bunker in April 1945.
Benito Mussolini created the Fascist Party in Italy in the year 1990, eventually making himself the dictator of Italy from the year 1925 to 1945 prior to the World War II. Italy to military victories in Libya, Somalia, Albania and Ethiopia. He wanted to recreate Italy as a Roman Empire with himself as Caesar. As second deus, meaning the leader. He allied himself with Adolf Hitler during the World War II. He was killed in 1945.
I'm going to say about the timeline of World War II. 1939. Hitler's invasion of Poland on 1st September 1939 was the beginning of World War II in Europe. 9th March 1939, Germany invaded Poland. 1940, Germany, Poland and Belgium was overwhelmed by Germany. Churchill became the Prime Minister. Evacuation of British force from Dunkirk. 1941. Hitler began Operation Barbarossa in June 1, 1941. Codename for the invasion of the Soviet Union. Japanese military strike on the US naval base Pearl Harbor. This was a turning point in World War II. This made America enter into the war.
Germany surrendered at Stalingrad. Germany's defeat at Stalingrad was a turning point in World War II and is regarded as one of the bloodiest battles in modern history. During November 1942, Soviet received reinforcements and launched Operation Uranus, which destroyed Nazis' northern and southern flanks. The Soviet encircled more than 250,000 men of the Nazi 6th Army. Soon accepting the defeat, the Marshal of German Army surrendered his troops on February 2, 1943. Thus, the surrender of Stalingrad became a pivotal victory for the Soviet Union. Invasion of Italy. The Allied invasion of Italy took place on 3rd September 1943 following the successful invasion of Sicily. It led to the collapse of Mussolini's government and he was forced to resign and arrested later on that day. On September 3rd, Montgomery's 8th Army began its invasion in Italian mainland and the Italian government agreed to surrender to the Allied forces.
The Battle of Stalingrad, which began on 23rd August 1942, was a turning point in World War II. It was the German Army's first major setback. Singapore falls to Japanese. The Japanese invaded Singapore in February 1942, as Singapore was a British stranglehold. Churchill referred to the event as the worst disaster in military history. The Battle of Midway. The Battle of Midway took place in the Pacific in the June of 1942. It was the crucial and decisive naval battle which eventually saw the Americans as victorious.
Indian soldiers were compelled by the Britishers to join their army in World War II. Now my friends will speak about the background of the Indian soldiers in World War II.
The Indians took part in the World War II because they needed money to sustain their family. There were not many other good jobs back then for those in the profession. They were not forcefully dragged or anything. Majority of them voluntarily joined the army. It was the largest army in World War II.
Since 1857, Britain went after communities where there is a strong culture of martial jobs. Think of Sikhs, Goraks, etc. There is a strong push to show bravery. Their default position at that time was to join the army. The only available army to join was the British Indian Army. If your father, grandfather, brothers, uncles have all served in the army, you would have both pride and pressure to join the army. Many of them cheerfully joined.
Hello, today we are going to talk about individual contributions, their names and lives. Fazaldin. He was all of 23 years old when he bravely fought off Japanese troops in 1945. He was an acting naik in the 7th Battalion, 10th Baloch Regiment. At the ambush at Mektala in Burma, Din's troops were surrounded by three bunkers on one side and a house on the other. Without a second's thought, Din threw grenades at the bunker closest to him and silenced it. Then he led his troops forward despite heavy firing from the other bunkers. When he was faced with Japanese soldiers, he didn't back down. One of the soldiers stabbed him with his sword, but he pulled the sword out of him and stabbed the soldier back, killing him. Despite a gaping hole in his body, he went to kill more enemy soldiers, all the while encouraging his troops. He lost his life soon after recording his statement.
Yashwant Gadge. Young 22-year-old Gadge was a naik with the 5th Maratha Light Infantry serving in the Upper Tiber Valley in Italy. The troops he was commanding came under heavy firing, injuring and killing many soldiers. As the enemy platoon advanced forward, he rushed to a machine gun. He threw a grenade which shook off some of the advancing platoon and then fired at whoever was left. But two men from the enemy platoon still came forward. Gadge, not getting the time to reload his weapon, instead picked up his gun and struck two men on their heads, killing them. But he missed a sniper hidden at a distance and was shot fatally. Thank you.
Rao Abdul Hafiz Khan was 18 when he was serving the British Indian Army as a Jamadar in the 9th Jat Regiment. In April 1944, he was fighting at the Battle of Imphal, where he was ordered to lead his platoon to an enemy position. He had led them across a bare slope and climbed up a steep hill. During the climb, the enemy opened fire and threw grenades, injuring him. But he climbed on nevertheless and he reached the enemy bunker on the crest, snatched a machine gun from a soldier with his bare hands, while another man killed the gunner. He led his platoon forward, eliminating the enemy one by one. He had received machine gun wounds, but even as he fell, his hands did not leave the trigger, firing at the enemy.
The infantry was the workhorse of the military. Air defense artillery was first established by the British government. Now, my friends will talk about the different types of soldiers who fought in World War II.
Air defense artillery in India was first established by the British government ruling India in 1939 at the start of World War II to counter the growing aerial threat from the Axis powers, especially from the Japanese in East Asia. A small number of Indian troops were initially trained to use 3-inch attack guns and in the later stages of the conflict to operate Bofors 40mm L-60 guns. The trained troops formed part of the anti-aircraft batteries of the Hong Kong and Singapore Royal Artillery to counter the Japanese air threat in Southeast Asia. In July 1940, the government established training schools for anti-aircraft and coastal defense wings at Karachi. By 1942, the air defense branch had grown considerably with 18 operational anti-aircraft regiments, of which 9 were high-altitude airship regiments and 9 were low-altitude airship regiments. However, after actively taking part in the Second World War on behalf of the British Empire, many of these were disbanded. Thank you.
Infantry. Infantry was a workhorse of the military, not only because of battling the enemy at the war, but also as the physical labor at the front lines, like transporting the food, clothes, and weapons needed to win the war. They experienced the war as no one else did.
It was invited to form an armed division in the plains for 1940, 1941, and 1942. However, the Indian armed formation suffered from a lack of equipment and the shortage of tanks in 1948 was reflected in the organization of 31st Armed Division, which first had one and arm and the two motors brigades. Thank you.
Would it be thrilling to know about the stories of soldiers for that time for real? Now we have among us a veteran soldier's role play played by my friends.
Good morning and welcome to yet another episode of India's Unsung Heroes. I'm your host Adit Rao. Today we have a very special guest, Major Arjun Nayak. It is an honor and privilege to have you here with us. Welcome to the show, Major.
Mr. Adit Rao, it's a very great pleasure to be here with you.
To begin with, would you like to tell us what motivated you to join the Indian Army?
I was once a 6-year-old child when my uncle joined the army. He had took his training very greatly. One day, he was appointed to fight a war with Berlin. He had fought very bravely and made our India proud and safe. He was my motivation to be here.
How did your military experience affect your life?
After I joined the military, my life was very hard. I had missed very important functions in my family. I had very less holidays to go and meet my loved ones. I had missed my family a lot.
Could you share a funny moment that happened in your life as a soldier?
This was very funny moment in my life of military experience. So, it was a very normal day and I looked for intruders. So, I found a man hiding near a bush and I called my team. Then, when we went and saw, son, it was a baby gorilla's leg.
That must have been hilarious. what message would you like to share with the youth of tomorrow?
Like everyone who is part of India and who likes to defend our country and make our country safe and sound can join the army and give their best to defeat the invaders who want to capture our land, India. This is an invitation from the Indian Army.
Thank you, sir, for the beautiful message. It has been a pleasure to have you here. I wish you all the best.
Thank you, Mr. Adit Rao, and thank you everyone for supporting me and guiding me to this stage.
That's it for today. See you next time on yet another episode of India's Unsung Heroes.
Indian women have played vital role during World War II. Now my friends will speak about the contribution of Indian women during World War II.
Indian soldiers during the World War II. Contribution of women during the war. Role of women during the World War II. During World War II, women worked in factories producing munitions, building ships, airplanes, the auxiliary services as air raid wardens, fire officers and evacuation officers, as drivers of fire engines, trains and trams, as conductors and as nurses. As with their counterparts in the United States and Europe, women were not allowed to serve in combat roles. Instead, they worked behind the front lines as typists, switchboard operators, and drivers, and could be posted anywhere the Indian Army was deputed. Here are a few pictures of women working as nurses and doctors. Women were required by the government to serve. At first, only single women aged 20 to 30 were called up, but by mid-1943, almost 90% of single women and 80% of married women were working in factories on the land or in the armed forces. Huge number of women were involved in the war effort and many joined the armed forces even though they did not have to. 6,40,000 in the armed forces, 55,000 serving with guns and providing essential air defense, 80,000 in the land army, plus many more who flew unarmed aircrafts, drove ambulances, worked as nurses, and worked behind enemy lines in the European resistance. Here are a few pictures of women serving in the army.
Good morning, my name is Nivedita. I am going to tell about contribution of women in World War II, India. By 1942, the threat of a Japanese invasion of India was looming large. So the British formed the Women's Auxiliary Corps India for female volunteers to contribute to the war cause. The first and only time until 1992, women served the Indian Army in non-medical roles. These are some pictures of the women. In India, several young Indian women, mostly college graduates and school teachers, had started joining the Women Royal Indian Naval Services. They lived in military-style hostels that were run by women officers while training for a multitude of shore jobs. The Indian Women Royal Indian Naval Services wore white saris with blue borders and seaman's arm badges. The sari design of women in World War II. Lakshmi Sanghal. In 1971, Sanghal joined the Communist Party of India, Marxist, and represented the party in Rajya Sabha. During the Bangladesh crisis, she organized relief camps and medical aid in Calcutta for refugees who streamed into India from Bangladesh. She was one of the founding members of All India Democratic Women's Association in 1981 and led many of its activities and campaigns. She led a medical team to Bhopal after the gas tragedy in December 1984, worked towards restoring peace in Kanpur following the anti-Sikh riots of 1984, and was arrested for her participation in a campaign against the Miss World competition in Bangalore. Picture of Lakshmi Sagar.
Contribution of women in World War II. India. Kalyani Singh, a second officer and the first Indian service woman who visited the UK. served in the Women's Royal Indian Naval Service of the Royal Indian Navy during the World War II. Sen married to a colonel of the Indian Army, accepted with alacrity and left her 2 month study visit in the company of Margaret Cooper, a British officer who served in the Marines. This is the picture of Kalyani Sen and her family. Sardar Tukral, from 1914 to 15 March 2008, was the first Indian woman to fly an aircraft, born in 1914. She earned an aviation pilot license in 1936 at the age of 21 and flew a Gibson Moth solo. She had a 4-year-old daughter. After obtaining the initial license, she persevered and completed 1,000 hours of flying in the aircraft owned by the Lahore Flying Club. Her husband, P.D. Sharma, whom she married at 16 and who came from a family which had 9 pilots, encouraged her. This is the picture of Sarla Tukral.
In the modern times, when things get digitalized, we have among us a digital photo album about heroes who fought in Southeast Asia and Europe.
Heroes who fought in Europe, Southeast Asia. Mohan Singh. Mohan Singh was an Indian military officer and a member of the Indian independence movement, best known for his few roles in organizing and leading the first Indian National Army in Southeast Asia during World War II. Following Indian independence, Mohan Singh later served in public life as a member of parliament in the Rajya Sabha of the Indian Parliament. Sam Manekshaw. Sam Manekshaw was the chief of the army, staff of the Indian Army during the Indo-Pakistan War of 1971 and the first Indian Army officer to be promoted to the rank of Field Marshal. His military career spanned 4 decades and 5 wars, beginning with the service in the British Indian Army in World War II. Naik Fazluddin. Fazluddin was an Indian Muslim recipient. The Victoria Cross, the highest award for gallantry in the face of the enemy that can be awarded to British and Commonwealth forces. Fazluddin was 23 years old and an acting naik in the 7th Battalion of 10th Balut Regiment, Indian Army, during when the following deed took place for which he was awarded the Victoria Cross.
Namdeo Jadhav VC, 18th November 1921 to 2nd August 1984, was an Indian recipient of the Victoria Cross, the highest and most prestigious award for gallantry in the face of the enemy that can be awarded to British and Commonwealth forces. Jadhav was 23 years old and a sepoy in the 1st Battalion, 5th Maratha Light Infantry in the Indian Army during World War II. When the following deed took place during the spring 1945 offensive in Italy, for which he was awarded the VC. Karamjit Singh Judge. Karamjit Singh Judge VC, 25th May 1923 to 18th March 1945. Was an Indian recipient of the Victoria Cross, the highest and most prestigious award for gallantry in the face of the enemy that can be awarded to British and Commonwealth forces. He was commissioned as an infantry subaltern at Ambala before transferred to 39th Indian Division, nearing an important moment in the large West War. When the Allies were about to launch the largest counter-offensive of the war so far, he arrived with 4th Battalion into the British 14th Army to make the drive for Rangoon. Abdul Hafiz, Rao Abdul Hafiz Panwar, 4th September 1925 to 6th April 1944, was an Indian recipient of the Victoria Cross, the highest and most prestigious award for gallantry in the face of the enemy that can be awarded to British and Commonwealth forces. He was the youngest Indian recipient of the award. He was one of the 3 World War II VCs awarded for action in British India, the others being awarded to John Pennington Harmon and John Neil Randall, both at the Battle of Kohima.
The Bengal famine started in the year 1943 during the World War II. Approximately 3 million people died in this famine. This famine was caused due to an increased demand for food. The factors of Bengal famine was a shortage of rice supply and inefficient allocation of food. There were so many reasons for the shortage of rice. One of the main reasons was the Japanese army bombed the capital of Burma, Rangoon, which meant nearly 5 lakh people migrated from Burma to India via Bengal. The refugees spread pandemic diseases like malaria, cholera, smallpox, dysentery that made the famine more complicated. The British government prioritized the allocation of vital supplies to the military and civil servants. The government never declared that it was a state of famine, so finance and resource needs increased.
Nobel Prize winning economist Amartya Sen's Poverty and Famines, an essay on entitlement and deprivation, 1981, argues the famine was manufactured and not natural. Later research has confirmed that those people whose lives were already financially precarious starved because they couldn't afford to buy food rather than being an overall shortage of its supply.
Pictorial representation gives us a clarity. Images of hunger and starvation will be presented now.
The Bengal famine in 1943 was a famine in the Bengal province of British India during World War II. An estimated 2.1/3 million out of a population of 60.3 million died of starvation, malaria, or other diseases aggravated by malnutrition, population displacement, unsanitary conditions, and lack of health care. The primary reason for the famine was shortages in rice.
The Japanese were very brutal to their prisoners of war. Prisoners of war endured gruesome tortures with rats and ate grasshoppers for nourishment. Some were used for medical experiments and target practice. About 50,000 Allied prisoners of war died, many from brutal treatment. Some of the key reasons for starvation are ever-increasing financial and resource needs due to the war, the Japanese invasion of Burma, which cut off food and other essential supplies to the region, mismanagement by Indian regional governments, increase in demand partially as a result of refugees from Burma and Bengal.
British states of India had to provide the British soldiers. Now my friends will talk about the involvement of princely states during World War II.
A princely state, also called as a native state or an Indian state, was a vassal state under a local ruler with an alliance with the British Raj. During the Second World War, there were more than 600 princely states in India. The major princely states were Mysore, Baroda, Jammu and Kashmir, Gwalior and Hyderabad. The princely states provided 2,50,000 men with the Indian states forces. The Indian states forces serviced in Malaya, Burma, North Africa, the Middle East and Italy, while others served as garrison in India. 5 ISF battalions were part of the garrison of Singapore when it fell to the Japanese in February 1942. Here there are pictures of soldiers of Indian States Forces.
Imperial service troops were the forces raised by the princely states under the British Indian Army. Troops were available for service the Indian Army when such service was requested by the British government. Beginning of 20th century, their total number were 18,000 men. Troops were routinely inspected by the British Army and generally had the same equipment as the soldiers in the British Indian Army. Numbers were relatively small.
My classmates will speak about INA and Subhash Chandra Bose.
Subhash Chandra Bose was, war,
was born on 23rd January 1897 and died on 18th August 1945. He was an Indian nationalist whose defiant patriotism made him a hero in India, but whose attempt during World War II was to get rid of India of the British rule with the help of Nazi Germany and Imperial Japan that left a troubled legacy. INA was revived under the leadership of Subhash Chandra Bose after his arrival in Southeast Asia in 1943. The army was declared to be the army of Bose's Arzi Hukumat-e-Azad-Hind, Azad-Hind Fauj. Under Bose's leadership, the INA drew ex-prisoners and thousands of civilian volunteers from the Indian expatriate population in Malaya, present-day Malaysia, and Burma. This second INA fought along with the Imperial Japanese Army against the British and Commonwealth forces in the campaigns in Burma, at Imphal and Kohima, and later against the Allied retaking of Burma. Thank you.
This is the scene between the Indian National Army fighting against the Axis forces, which consisted of Germany, Italy, and Japan. The Indian Army during World War II was the largest Allied forces. At the height of the Second World War, 2.5 million Indian troops were fighting Axis forces around the globe. Nearly 2.5 million volunteer Indian soldiers fought throughout World War II for the Allies. Over 87,000 Indian soldiers died. Indian National Army, INA, was formed by Indian National and Imperial Japan during World War II. The army was formed by the British Indian Army, captured by Japan during World War II. The aim was to secure Indian independence from British rule. The army was first formed in 1942 under Mohan Singh. First INA collapsed and then Raj Bihari Bose handed over the INA to Subhash Chandra Bose.
It is time for us now to throw some light about World War II. Now my friends will brief about the results of World War II.
Destruction. Millions lost their lives and millions were wounded. An estimated death toll of World War II was around 8 crores. Vast lands were left in ruins. Millions were left homeless. The Allies defeated the dictators, the Nazis, and the fascists. Germany was occupied by the Allies. The Second World War II led to the lowering of the status of France and England, and to the emergence of superpowers of Russia and America as superpowers. This led to the end of the vast colonial empires of the Allies. Colonies declared themselves independent, distinction all throughout the world, including in the European theater against Germany, in North Africa against Germany and Italy, in the South Asian region defending India from the Japanese and fighting the Japanese in liberating British colonies such as Singapore and Hong Kong. After the Japanese surrender in 1945, August 1945,
8,000 Indian soldiers, including those from modern day Pakistan, Nepal and Bangladesh, died in World War II. Indian Army during World War II was one of the largest Allied force contained, which took part in the North.
Returning of Indian soldiers from World War II. The War Department promised that all servicemen were eligible for demobilization from Europe would be in US by February 1946, and from the Pacific by June 1946. 1 million men were discharged from the military in December 1945. The problem faced by the returning invaders are well known: unemployment, homeless, post-traumatic stress disorder, PTSD, and difficulty in getting benefits. But those challenges were hidden from the greatest generation, the generation that fought World War II.
Yeah.